It's important to be prepared for what is about to come when a foreigner enters into a relationship with a Filipina. For the uninitiated, there can be many things that can certainly surprise you when you first go to meet her in the Philippines. In fact, some may not only surprise you, but outright shock you. So if you're a foreign guy who's thinking of dating a Filipina, or is already in a relationship with a Filipina and is yet to go and meet her in person, then you don't want to miss these very insightful 10 tips. So be sure to stay with me here. Just quickly, if you're looking to date a Filipina and don't know where to start, then why not check out my affiliate link in the pinned comment and description to the Philippines' number one dating site, where it's free to create an account and view tens of thousands of beautiful Filipina profiles right now. Now, what I'm going to give you here are 10 things that really stood out to me when I went to meet my Filipina for the very first time. No doubt, some may have experienced the same things as me, and others may have found his Filipina a little more different. So if you've met your Filipina and your experience was different, then please feel free to tell us of your experiences in the comments section below. Number one is probably one of the funniest things that I recall and still amuses me to this very day. And that is, sometimes when you ask her a question, she'll not verbalize her answer, but she'll purse her lips like she's about to kiss you and then point in the direction with her lips. For instance, you may ask her, "Where is the toilet?" And she'll purse her lips together and point in the direction of the toilet with her lips. She won't even say a word, which is far different to what we're used to in our country. Simply, in our country, you ask someone where is the toilet, and they'll tell you where you can find it. This is a common Filipino trait, and one that, to me at least, is rather amusing, but also endearing. Number two is something that I wasn't aware of, but probably should have been, before I went to meet my Filipina for the first time, and that was that she mostly ate food by using her hands. I remember going to the province with my new girlfriend to visit her family, and we all sat down outside to a family feast made up of mainly rice, chicken, and fish. My Filipina was kind enough to serve me my food, and I wondered, naively of course, where was the knife and fork? I then looked around the table and saw the family using their hands to eat, which I'm used to when I'm eating things like hamburgers or hot dogs, but certainly not with rice, chicken, and fish. I then looked at my Filipina, and she was doing the same thing, and she just smiled at me. So I thought, okay, let's just enjoy the cultural experience here, and I'll do likewise. It really wasn't a big deal, but at the time, it was certainly a little different, and something I really should have been aware of, especially when my girlfriend was from a province area where eating with one's hands is rather common. Number three is a follow-on from the previous point, and that is your Filipina, especially if she comes from a province area, may not be used to using cutlery, or for that matter, some may never have even used cutlery before. I know for my wife back then, when I took her to a restaurant, she wasn't overly confident around using cutlery. Not that she had never used it before, but growing up in a poorer family, it was something she rarely did. So of course, she would be unsure, especially in a public restaurant. So, of course, a big tip here is finding out how comfortable she is around using a knife and fork before you take her out to a nice restaurant. Mainly because you want to save her any possible embarrassment that may come about from her not knowing how to use cutlery, and this way, perhaps you could give her some pointers before going to a restaurant. Number four is that she may not use toilet paper. Now, us guys in foreign countries naturally assume everyone uses toilet paper, but commonly in the Philippines, and again, especially in province areas, this is not so. Two reasons for this are because the sewage system in many province areas aren't the same as we have in our country and aren't set up to handle toilet paper. And secondly, many families simply can't afford toilet paper as their money is needed more to buy the essential things in life. So imagine as a foreign guy, you walk into the toilet and you see what is a rather low set toilet with a bucket full of water and a scoop on the floor. Then you look around and to your horror, you see no toilet paper. And then of course it dawns on you what you need to do here. Now as I say, at first it's all shock and horror. But again, it's all part of the experience when dating a Filipina for many of us foreign guys. So guys, just be prepared before you meet your Filipina for the first time. Number 5 is that she may have some very strange superstitions. Now I found out over the years that many Filipino people do have superstitions that some actually believe. I remember my Filipina at one point telling me to be careful if I go to some areas in Visayas. And at the time I was puzzled as to why I should be careful. And she then went on to tell me about apparent stories of real vampires there. At that time I wasn't too sure if she was playing around with me or if she actually believed it. But what I can say is 8 years later, she certainly has very few of these superstitions as she's learning more about the world in general. Number 6 is that she really doesn't need to be taken to any fancy restaurants. Sure, it can be nice for you to take her, and you may feel good about doing so. But for some Filipinas, it can make them rather uncomfortable. So my best advice is not to assume that she would love to go and be excited about it because this for some Filipinas may cause anxiety. Simply just ask her if going to a nice restaurant is something that she would enjoy or be comfortable with, or would she rather go to a more basic place to eat such as Mang Inasal. Okay guys, here's one that you need to handle very carefully. And number 7 is that some Filipinas think they're awesome singers, and when they get on that karaoke machine to belt out some tunes, if she isn't as good as she thinks, it can be a potential diplomatic minefield to navigate. You certainly don't want to embarrass or upset her by telling her some home truths around her singing. But by the same token, you don't want to be going over the top and telling her that she could be the next Morissette Amon. And for those that don't know who Morissette Amon is, do yourself a favour and search for her on YouTube as she's totally awesome. But the truth is that many Filipinas love to sing, no matter if they're good at it or not. And certainly, not all will believe that they're good singers when they totally suck. To me, it's a curious thing to sit back and watch a rather shy woman change to a total rock star in a second when they get that karaoke microphone in their hands. So be prepared, guys, for plenty of karaoke if you intend on dating a Filipina. Number 8 is that she'll undoubtedly love spending much time with you and will really enjoy your private moments together. But equally, she'll enjoy spending time with her family and helping you to get to know her family a little better. So don't be put off or feel left out if she's always taking you to her family's house or introducing you to many relatives. This is her being proud of you and wanting you to get to know all of her large family because she wants you to also become a part of her family. Even when you're there visiting her relatives, she may disappear and leave you on your own for a period of time. Rest assured, She's not neglecting you, but her family is asking her many questions about you so that they can understand and get to know more about you. They may not feel comfortable themselves in speaking English to you, and so it's much easier to ask the Filipina these questions. Number 9 is that she'll look after you in a way you may never have experienced before from anyone apart from possibly your mother when you were sick. This is the time that you'll see a genuine, loving Filipina step up as she'll be genuinely concerned for you. It's not wonderful that you got sick, but certainly it's wonderful to see just how much care a woman can have for her man. Number 10 is that a genuine Filipina will commit and love you in a way like you most likely have never experienced before. Many of us who have only previously ever been in relationships with women in our own country may think that the women may have loved you and been fully committed to you and the relationship. And at one point, we may have totally believed it. That is, until you see what true commitment and love is from a Filipina. I know for me, I was truly blown away, and it was something I never had felt or experienced before. The feeling is something impossible for me to describe, but to this day, after being together for 8 years, I still have the same feeling inside, and I know in my mind that this is something I never want to lose. If you're looking for more valuable, free information and tips around predating a Filipina, then be sure to check out the playlist on screen now. And be very sure to subscribe, and I'll see you in the next video.